Brothers, elders, sisters, and visitors. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tremendously for granting us and allotting us this opportunity to come today on this blessed and sacred day to perform our Salatul Jum'ah. I do hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our coming, and may Allah reward us tremendously both in dunya and akhirah. Next week will be Thanksgiving. Today, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I would like to speak on Thanksgiving from an Islamic perspective. It is essential and of paramount importance to be habitually grateful and thankful for every favor, every bounty, and to be appreciative for every blessing, big or small, granted to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The concept of being grateful, and I will use the word again, habitually, not occasionally, but habitually grateful and thankful to Allah, is emphasized in the Quran. And the word shukr, which is the word for thanks and gratitude in Arabic, ash-shukr, this word is mentioned in the Quran in about 73 places in different forms. This by itself tells us how important is the concept of being grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the beautiful attributes of Allah, one of the beautiful quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is Allah is ash-shakur, the one who appreciates appreciation and thanks, the one worthy of true thanks, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the giver of every ni'mah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the giver of every bounty we have or we receive in whatever shape or form it is in us. Islam teaches us that there is no specific day, no specific time, no special occasion or event in the year set aside to give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا, that if perchance you would want to count and enumerate the countless bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, لا تحصوها, that it would be impossible. It would be impossible for you to count the grace and the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. The more we thank Allah, the more we appreciate Allah's appreciations, His rewards, His blessings, His mercies, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase His favors upon us. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, if you habitually thank me and express His gratitude to my enormous boons and favors upon you, لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, I will continue to grace you, I will continue to shower you with my favors. The rewards of shukr, the rewards of thanks is unlimited without measure. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again says in the Quran, فَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِي. Shukr and thanks is so important that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever is grateful, whoever is thankful, whoever expresses gratitude regularly, فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُهُ لِنَفْسِي, and he is doing so for his own self, he becomes the beneficiary of that thanks and that grace. Nothing is created for us simply to use as we wish. The reason for all the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on man is to direct, to connect, and to interact man towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because everything given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala necessitates gratitude in return. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously gives. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never stopped giving. Allah continuously gives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives and forgives. Man gets and forgets. Man receives and disregards. So in return, we should sincerely express gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was gratitude and thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that underlay the modesty and the maturity of the prophets. Like Dawud alayhi salam, like Sulaiman alayhi salam, to whom great possessions were given, status were given, sovereignty were given. These anbiya, these prophets remain grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they always attribute success to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was never me or I when it comes to gratefulness or thanks. It was always attributed to Allah. This is the grace of Allah upon me. This is the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon me. It was never because of my abilities, of my capabilities. It was never because of me and I. It was always because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And on the flip side of the coin, Qaarun, who was also given possession, became arrogant and deranged on account of his wealth and possession because of disregarding the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him. It's because of being ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes gratitude. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes ingratitude. The remembrance of Allah and thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes hand in hand. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ. Remember me and I will remember you. وَاشْكُرُونِي, and thank me. Be habitually grateful and thankful to me. وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ And do not be ungrateful. People are categorized into two categories. The people of shukr, the people of gratitude, and the people of kufr, the people of ingratitude. Look in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the word kufr for ingratitude. وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ Allah categorized people into two categories. The people of thanks and the people who don't give thanks. The people of gratitude and the people of ingratitude. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He, Allah, likes the people of gratitude and also gratitude. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes ingratitude and the people of ingratitude. As Allah tells us in the Quran, وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجِدَيْنِ We have shown man the two ways, the right way and the wrong way. The way leading towards success and the way leading to destruction. It is a choice. Being grateful is a choice. Being ungrateful is a choice. As Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا And we have shown you the two ways. Either you be grateful or you be ungrateful. And if you choose to be ungrateful, and if you choose to be occasionally grateful to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِن تَكْفُرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكُمْ If you are ungrateful to Allah, if you do not express thanks to Allah, Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of your occasionally thanks. وَلَا يَرْضَى بِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفُرِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like ingratitude from His servants. وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ And if you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you express His thanks to Allah, يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciates that from you. Shaitan, the devil, when he realized that the rewards of gratitude is unlimited, if you look at the other a'mals, the other deeds, the rewards are limited. The rewards for shukr and thanks and gratefulness is unlimited in the sight of Allah. لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ Allah says He will continue to give to you. How much it is not mentioned. So when the devil realized that the reward for thanks and gratefulness is unlimited, he made it his mission to keep man away from being truly grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shaitan says, I will attack them from in front, and from behind, and from the right side, and from the left side. I will make them feel, and I will make them think that it is not happening, or it is happening because of me. It has happened because of me. It has happened because of my abilities and my capabilities. Shaitan said, I will not make them think that it happened because Allah wanted it to happen. I will not make them think it is happening because Allah wants it to happen. I will make them think they earned that degree because of their own abilities. They earned that wealth because of their own capabilities. They become cured from being sick because of the doctors, not because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when someone thinks like that, Shaitan challenges Allah by saying, وَلَا تَجِدْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ Oh Allah, you will find very few of your servants being thankful to you. Really grateful and thankful to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another ayah of the Quran, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُرُ The word qaleel is used, not al-qaleel. قَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِي very few of my servants will be really grateful and thankful to me in the conditions that I put them in and in whatever I have given to them. We always complain. And we are always unsatisfied with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us or in the condition we are in. If we keep on complaining, then we will never be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِرَبِّهِ كَفُورًا Shaitan, the devil, was ungrateful to Allah. He always wanted more. What more he wanted? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him everything. But he wanted more. He wanted to be a leader. He wanted to be a leader of men. He wanted superiority. خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِن تِينٍ Oh Allah, you created Adam from clay and you created me from fire. I am superior to him. Why are you making man leader? Make me the leader. So he wanted more. And when more was not given to him, he became ungrateful. وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانِ لِرَبِّهِ كَفُورًا My dear respected brothers and elders, it is important that we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with every breath we take. The lowest form of gratitude is to realize and acknowledge that every blessing comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, irrespective of the cause of it. Every blessing comes from Allah. You don't need to know the cause of it. Our breathing, we breathe every day. Our breathing without thought. Yet each breath is a blessing from Allah. It is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we stop breathing, we die. So breath is a gift from Allah. An average person breathes about 15 to 20 times a minute. 180 times an hour. And about 36,000 times in a day. And each breath, each exhale, and each inhale is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should take away the breathing from a person, what will happen to that person? Do we know that when we breathe, this is a gift from Allah? 26,000 times a day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us that gift that you breathe. Do you thank me? Do we have to pay for the air we breathe? If you have to go into the hospital and an oxygen tank has to be attached to you, then you have to pay for that. Do we pay for the air that we breathe 36,000 times a day? Do we thank Allah for that? An average person's heart beats approximately 60 to 70 times per minute. 1,560 times an hour. And about 37,500 times a day, a person's heart beats. Before this heart beats every time, it takes permission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Should I continue beating or should I stop beating? Every beat, it's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every beat is a favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. An average person blinks his eye in about 16 times per minute. 960 times an hour. And in 16 hours, I'm not talking about 24 hours because you don't blink for 24 hours, you sleep. For 16 hours in the day, a person blinks averagely 15,000 times. Each time this eye blinks is a blessing from Allah. It is a gift from Allah, it is a favor from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran very beautifully, قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ سَمْعَكُمْ وَأَبْصَارَكُمْ وَقُلُوبَكُمْ Tell him, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should snatch away your ability of seeing, your ability of hearing, your ability of thinking and comprehending, who will bring that faculty back to you permanently? Is anyone capable enough to give you back that faculty of sight, that faculty of hearing, faculty of comprehension permanently back to you? No, no. Do we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on a daily basis for these ni'mah? The story of a man who could not urinate, 70 years old. He stopped urinating, he had a problem. He went to the doctor for the procedure. The procedure was done. The problem was taken care of. Again, he began urinating as he used to for 70 years. Before he left the hospital, a bill was presented before him for compensation. He looked at the bill and he began weeping. Someone asked him, "Why are you weeping? Don't you have the money to pay? No insurance, as we may say." He said, "No, no, everything is intact. I'm looking at this bill, and only today this realization dawned upon me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who was causing me to urinate for 70 years without a problem, never asked me for a bill one time. Today, this one human being has done the same work for me, the same thing for me, and before I leave, I have to pay. That Allah who did this for me for 70 years, I never realized how important is that ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that favor of Allah, that I give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that." Dawud alayhi salatu wassalam asked Allah, "O Allah, what is the least of your blessings upon man?" Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "O Dawud, breathe, take a breath." Dawud alayhi salatu wassalam took a breath. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "That is my least blessing upon you. That is my least blessing upon you." We see with the eye, if we continue to give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue to give to us. Allah will continue to be generous to us in every way. And when we are thankful, Allah, not only Allah will continue to give to us, people will also give to us. When you say thank you, the magic word thank you, people feel liked, people feel appreciated, people feel welcome, that someone has acknowledged my favor. Someone has acknowledged what I have done to him. My dear respected brothers and elders, be a grateful servant to Allah and you will see wonders in your life. Be a grateful servant to your Creator and you will see wonders in your life. Many of us today, we focus only on the problems and the difficulties of life. And we say in despair, why is life so difficult? We don't look optimistic. We are not optimistic. We always look at the glass half empty instead of half full. That is our attitude in life. We say in despair, why I must go through problems and difficulties? When we have all the basic necessities of life and we want something else, then ask yourself the question, do I really need what I don't have? Do I really need this? I don't need it. I just desire it. I just want it. Do I really need it? A person's life is a fluctuation between afflictions and blessings. Fluctuates. Allah says in Hadith al-Qudsi, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ الْأَمْرَ كُلَّهُ لَهُ خَيْرٍ وَلَيْسَ ذَٰلِكَ لِأَحَدْ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ السَّرَّاءَ شَكَرَ كَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ دَرَّاءَ فَصَبَرَ كَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. Fluctuation. You receive a blessing from Allah, you express His gratitude. Afflictions comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Difficult time comes, you patiently endure that, my dear respected brothers and elders. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, if shukr and sabr, if gratitude and patience and endurance were two camels, I would not mind which one of the two to ride. Why? Because both thanks and patience are provisions for a Muslim on his journey towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So important is to have the quality of shukr, being grateful, and to have the quality of endurance, to be patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. One of the reasons for Allah creating us is to be thankful. هُوَ الَّذِي أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when we took you out from the wombs of your mothers, you were ignorant. لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. Where was your knowledge? You knew nothing. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. We have given you the ability of seeing. We have given you the ability of hearing. Why? In return, what do we want? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So you may thank us. You may be grateful to us. You may express gratitude. The gratitude of the tongue, that we constantly praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam says, remembering Allah's blessing and speaking of it increases it. Increases it. So always speak about the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The gratitude of the heart is to constantly recognize the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Recognize, acknowledge what Allah has given to you. It's not because of me. It is not because of what I have. It is because of Allah. Remember I said prophets attributed their success to Allah, who were given kingdom that no one will ever be given. لا ينبغي لأحد. Allah says, لَا يَنْبَغِي لَأَحَدٍ. Sulaiman alayhi salam was given such a kingdom that would not be given to any man until Qiyamah. But he attributed his success to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Gratitude with a deed is to make every blessing a manner of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. Thank Allah through your a'mals and your actions and do it to please Allah. Abu Hazim rahmatullahi alayhi says that every blessing that does not bring a person close to Allah, that in fact is an affliction for him. If a ni'mat of Allah, if a bounty of Allah that Allah has given to you does not bring you close to Allah, then that is a disaster in your favor. Expressing gratitude is a choice. My dear respected brothers and sisters, if we have food in our refrigerator, clothes on our bodies, a roof over our head, and a place to sleep when the night comes, then we are richer than 75% of the world. I will say it again. If we have food in our refrigerator, if we have clothes in our bodies, not fancy clothes, not brand names, we have to live a simple life. A Muslim is someone who lives very simple. If we have food in our refrigerator, we have clothes in our body, we have a roof over our head, not a mansion, but a roof, and a place to sleep in the night, then you are richer more than 75% of the world. If you have money in your pocket, then you are among the top 8% of wealthiest people in the world. Money in your pocket. 8% of wealthiest people in the world. If you woke up this morning with more health than sickness, then you are more blessed than the person who would not survive the day. Do we ever think about that? If you have never experienced the fear in a battle, if you have never experienced loneliness and of imprisonment, and the agony of torture, and the pangs of hunger, then you are ahead of 700 million people in the world. If you can attend the masjid without fear of harassment, like alhamdulillah, we can come to the masjid. This is one of the freedom we have here living in America. Freedom that we can come to our place of worship without any problem. If you are one of those people, then you are more blessed than 3 billion people around the world. If your parents are still alive and still married, if your parents are still alive and still married, then you are very rare. If you can smile, you are unique. In happy moments, praise Allah. In difficult moments, seek Allah. In quiet moments, remember Allah. In painful moments, trust Allah. And in every moment, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The will of Allah will not bring us to a place where the grace of Allah will not protect us. Subhanallah, what a beautiful statement. The will of Allah will not bring you to a place where the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not protect you. Locks are always made with keys. Have you ever seen a lock without a key? Similarly, problems are always made with solutions. There is never a problem without a solution. As-sabru nisful iman. Patience, half of faith, half of iman. Ibn Qayyim rahmatullahi alayhi writes, shukr, thanks, is one of the highest rank of iman. It is higher than the rank of qana'ah and contentment. And nobody can be content without being grateful. Grateful, contentment goes together. If you are content, you will be grateful. If you are not content, you will be ungrateful. Today, men are not content. That is why we are ungrateful. We always want to upgrade. We are in a process of upgrading. I have a phone, I want to upgrade my phone. I have a car, I want to upgrade my car. I have a house, I want to upgrade my house. So we are always in the process of upgrading. And when you are in the process of upgrading, brother, then you will not appreciate what you have. You will not appreciate what you have. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises those who are grateful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises the best rewards for those who are grateful. Shukr results in more favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very beautifully said, "Man lam yashkur al-qaleel, lam yashkur al-kathir." If a person cannot be thankful and appreciative for something small, he would never be thankful and appreciative for something big. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ النَّاسِ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ اللَّهِ. And if you cannot acknowledge and appreciate those whom you associate with, your friends, your relatives, your spouse, your siblings, those whom you associate with, لَمْ يَشْكُرِ اللَّهِ, and you cannot appreciate the favors of Allah upon you. If you cannot thank a human being, then you cannot thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Appreciating and mentioning the favors of Allah upon you is gratitude. And not mentioning the ni'mat of Allah upon you is ingratitude. Allah says, "Amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddith." Whatever Allah has blessed you with, mention it, but not with pride, not with arrogance, but in humility. That by itself is thanks. And real gratitude is to make use of what has been given to you in the correct way. For example, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you strength to worship Him, then say Alhamdulillah and use that strength to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't use that strength to disobey Allah. That is ingratitude. Huh? And whenever you remember a bounty of Allah upon you, whenever you remember a ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, then smile and say Alhamdulillah, because it is an ongoing process. One pious person, he thought of a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the past, and he said Alhamdulillah. After saying Alhamdulillah, he said, "Wow, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enabled me to say Alhamdulillah on a past favor." So he said Alhamdulillah again for saying Alhamdulillah. That Allah has given him the tawfiq to say Alhamdulillah. So he said Alhamdulillah again. So on saying Alhamdulillah the second time, he said, "Wow, again Allah has given me the opportunity and the ability to say Alhamdulillah the second time." So he realized that if I continue to say Alhamdulillah, it's from Allah. So it's an ongoing process. Keep on saying Alhamdulillah, it is an ongoing process. The more a person has, the more one should fear, the more one should be scared and be humble. Why? Will I be able to show enough gratitude for all that Allah has given to me? What a profound statement. The more, we always want more. We are never satisfied. We always want more. But think to yourself, the more I have, am I showing enough thanks to Allah? If I don't show that thanks to Allah habitually and more, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take it away from me. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who eats and gives thanks will have the reward of him who fasts for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are eating and you give thanks to Allah, and a man who is not eating and fasting, you will get the same reward as him. The one who gives thanks and enjoy good health will have the same reward of him who practices patience in his illness. And if patience is illness, subhanAllah, great rewards from Allah. But Allah has given you health and you are thankful, you get the same reward as someone who is sick and is patient. For the one whom Allah has given a favor and he gives thanks to Allah, then he gets the same reward as of him who is deprived and satisfied. The thanks of every ni'mah. Give thanks to Allah for every blessing, no matter how big or small it is. This is praise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected brothers and elders, life is beautiful. If one of our beloved ones is close to death, someone is dying from our family, it is only then when we witness that moment, we would start appreciating life more. When someone is dying who is close to you, beloved to you, and you know that is happening, only then probably you will start appreciating life more. The thought of them not surviving bring us or tell us how more precious life is all about. Remember, complaining is from shaitan. Let me tell you something. If you have problems, instead of speaking to your friends for an hour, at least make dua to Allah for 15 minutes. Why? Allah is the bringer of difficulties and Allah is the remover of difficulties. If you have problems, don't tell everything to human being. At least tell to Allah. Make dua for about 15 minutes. If you are sad, recite Surah Yusuf. A surah that brings happiness. And was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during the year of sadness. The year when his beloved wife Khadija radiallahu anha and his uncle Abu Talib, both of them whom he had loved the most, both of them passed away the same year. It was called, that year was called Amul Huzn, the year of sadness. Surah Yusuf was revealed to bring happiness and joy to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when you are depressed, and most of us are depressed most of the time, we are depressed most of the time. So when you are in depression, when you are in a state of depress, go back to the Quran, recite Surah Yusuf, you will cheer up. When you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will give you more. And when you give others, Allah will give you even more. Take out a few minutes in the morning and mentally thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to you. In the form of eyes, ears, hands, feet, limbs, organs, children, spouses, parents, good health. Take out about 10 to 15 minutes before you go off to work, after Salat al-Fajr. Think about these ni'mats of Allah and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do the same thing when you come back in the evening. Before you go to sleep, take out another 10 to 15 minutes and contemplate. Think about the same bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. Why? Because you will see that you will become more positive in life. Positivity brings positive outcome. Gratitude and abundance bring more abundance. Ata ibn Abdullah rahmatullahi alayhi sayyid, a very great saint. If you do not acknowledge the blessings of Allah you have, when you have them, if you do not acknowledge the blessings of Allah that you have when you have them, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will teach you about them by taking them away from you. Don't wait until you are without, then to appreciate what you have. And don't use your blessings to accumulate sins. Do not use your blessings to accumulate sins. If Allah has blessed you with a few dollars, then don't go to the casinos. Don't go to the gamble places. Do not what? Use the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accumulate sins, brother. This is nashukri. This is ungratefulness to Allah. You can choose to use this tongue to backbite. And at the same time, you can choose to use this tongue to do dhikr of Allah. You can choose to use this tongue to abuse people. And at the same time, you can choose to use this tongue to speak good of people. You can use your wealth to earn haram and riba. And you can use your wealth at the same time to give sadaqah. You can use your health to obey Allah, and you can use your health to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever you are in a state of difficulty or ease, then make a prostration of shukr before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the things that you have before you start asking for the things that you don't have. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said on the day of Qiyamah, إِذَا جَمَعَ اللَّهُ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخِرِينَ When everyone will assemble before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah, يُنَادِي مُنَادٍ An announcer will announce on the permission of Allah, سَيَعْلَمُ أَهْلُ الْجَمْعِ الْيَوْمَ مَنْ أَوْلَى بِالْكَرَمِ Today it will be known and become manifest as to who have rank and status in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the announcer will say, those people should stand up. What kind of people? الَّذِينَ تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا Those people should stand up who used to spend some portion of the night separated from their beds in front of Allah, communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where are those people who used to forgo their sleep in the night and stand before Allah? Come today. Today you have privilege in the sight of Allah. Separate yourselves. The announcement will be made again. Where are those people? الَّذِينَ كَانَتْ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ Many of us fall in this category. Where are those people whose their business, their jobs, their professions did not stop them from remembering Allah? Did not stop them from carrying out their duties and obligations to Allah? Where are those people? At Jum'ah time you are still working. Where is the barakah then? لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله Where are those people? A small group will stand up again. It will be said, you are the people of rank and status today. And then the announcement will be made again. Where are those people? الذين يحمدون الله في السراء والضراء Where are those people who used to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thank Allah in every condition and every situation, in ease and adversity, in health and in sickness, in wealth and in poverty? Wahum qaleel, another small group will stand up and they will be separated. Thumma yuhasabu sa'ir al-nas. Then hisab and accountability will start for everyone. These small groups of people will be separated. Are we in any of these groups? Ask ourselves, are we in any of these groups? Are we trying to be in any of these groups? Do we want our hisab to be taken on the day of Qiyamah? On that day when people will be running from pillar to post? When a man will be running for one deed? A very horrible, horrendous, terrific day, as we are told. Put ourselves in one of these categories, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Musa alayhi salatu wassalam, ask Allah, O Allah, how was it possible for Adam to be grateful to you? For there are additional favors of yours on Adam. What are the additional favors of Allah on Adam? خَلَقْتَهُ بِيَدِكَ Oh Allah, you created him with your own hands. وَأَسْكَنَهُ فِي الْجَنَّةِ Oh Allah, you made him reside in paradise. So much of your additional favors upon him. And when Allah subhanahu, what it means that you have created him with your own hands, it means according to how that is with Allah in its own connotation. We don't go in details of that. لَيْسَ لَهُ يَدٌ كَأَيْدِينَا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have hands like us. So in its own connotation, in its own context, oh Allah, you have created Adam and you have favored him more than anybody else. How did Adam thank you? Musa alayhi salatu wa salam said. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, oh Musa, listen carefully. All that I have given to Adam, Adam alayhi salam recognizes that all of those favors are from me. And he praised me. And on merely praising me, this is a sign of gratitude and gratefulness to me. That you acknowledge and recognize, like, I don't know how much more to emphasize this point, because this is our weakness today. We do not recognize and acknowledge that what we have is from Allah. This ego comes into us. This self comes into us. You have to take this out from our heart, or else Allah will deprive us. Allah will deprive us. What Allah says, Adam acknowledged that whatever favors he had that I had given to him, it is from me, and he thanked me for that. He acknowledged it. So we should also be acknowledging Allah. Allah says, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ Why would Allah punish you? مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ If you are grateful to Allah, gratefulness removes the adab of Allah. وَآمَنْتُمْ And you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the person who is blessed with four things in life, فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ One who is blessed with four things in life, then he has been given the best of this world and the best of the hereafter. What are these four things? Subhanallah. Lisanan dhakira. A tongue that is moist in the remembrance of Allah. Nothing abusing people, not in cursing people, not in saying bad things to people. But one that says good. Being a good person. Good. Use good words to others. Today if you go, if you hear certain conversations, even with our kids and our children today, every probably third word is a curse. Immorality has stepped in so much that the sentence cannot be completed morally without one bad word. Lisanan dhakira, a remembering tongue. Qalban shakira, number two, the heart that is full of gratitude to Allah. But in all time, badanan sabira, the third. A body that endures hardship in the matters of deen. Today we can work 3 and 4 jobs and it does not matter. But when it comes to sit for 1 hour for Islam, it's difficult. It is difficult. Where is that endurance? And the fourth is zawjatan mu'minatan saliha. A man who is blessed with a pious and a God-fearing, a God-conscious wife. If anyone is blessed with these four things, then he is given the best of this world and the best of the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's favors upon man is beyond comprehension. Once Sulaiman alayhi salam, the great king, he was moving on his throne. Someone looked at him and said, Subhanallah, what a scenario. What a scene. Sulaiman flying on his throne with hundreds of thousands of people. Subhanallah, he said, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed him with such wealth. Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam said, Arba'u khisalin man kunna fihi faqad u'tiya khayran mimma u'tiya ala Dawud min ad-dunya. Don't look at what I have and what Allah has given me. Let me tell you what you can have, he said. Four things. If it is found in a person, then you have been given more than what I have been given and my entire family. You have four things in you, then whatever I have, don't look at this. This is material. then you will have more than one, not only me, I mean Ali Dawood, myself and my whole family. What is number one? Khashyatullah fi sirri wal alaniya. The fear of Allah, the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, publicly and privately. Maybe we fear Allah publicly when people are around. But look at our lives privately. It's a different ball game. It's a different thing altogether. To say astaghfirullah publicly may not have or carry the same effect if you would say astaghfirullah privately. Because the sin that you would say astaghfirullah privately on, the same sin probably you may be committing secretly. The khashyatullah fi sirri wal alaniya. Second, aqastu fil ghina wal faqr. Moderation in poverty and wealth. You know what? We buy things we don't need with money that we don't have to impress people we don't know. What is it? We buy things that we don't need with money that we don't have. Next week will be Black Friday. We don't need money that we don't have to do what? To impress people we don't know. The third is al-adlu fil ghadabi wal ridha. And to exercise justice when you're happy and when you're angry. Be the same person. Temperament, no split personality. Huh? If you exercise justice in happiness, make sure you do it when you're angry. Do not be a different person when you're angry. And the fourth is alhamdulillah fi sirri wa fi sarai wa dara. And praising of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in good times and in bad times. And I will conclude because the time is up. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the position of a believer in relation to me is the best when he praises me, even at the time when I am pulling out his soul from his body. Subhanallah. The position of a believer with me is the best. That we always thank me, even when I am pulling out his soul from his body. When a man faces with difficulties and he prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah removed those difficulties, and he's now cured, shaitan, the devil comes to him and whispers to him and tells him, it was not that bad. It was not that bad anymore. So when shaitan whispers to him, oh, my sickness was not that bad. Allah cured him. Oh, it was not that bad. It was just something meager. So what happens then? When you say that, your appreciation and your thanks decreases. It decreases. Very much it decreases. I will quote this last story. One worshipper worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for 50 years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him that go, I have forgiven you and granted you paradise. The man said, forgive me for what? I didn't sin, I didn't commit wrong. Why you say you've forgiven me? So Allah says, okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused a nerve in his neck to give him pain. One nerve to give him pain in his neck. Became perturbed, can't sleep, pain, can't do anything. It happened that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him shifa once again and cured him. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after giving him cure, sent the angel to him. The angel came to him and he complained to the angel that he was suffering from a pain in his neck, and then he got cured. So the angel said, you know what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you cure, and now Allah has sent me to you. That all your 50 years of worship, Allah wants it back in exchange for the cure he gave you from your next pain. Can your 50 years of worship compensate for that one cure of your neck pain that Allah has given to you? All the bounties that we are receiving, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should take an account for us, would we be able to give an account to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah? No. One man, he had nothing on him. No good condition. Someone saw him, he was praising Allah all the time. said, you are praising Allah and you have no favor of Allah on you, no bounty of Allah on you, and you are still praising Allah? He said, yes, I have those bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on me, that if anyone will ask me to give it to them, no matter for how much, I would not give it to them. And he was referring to the limbs and the organs of his body. Materially, he had nothing. That is our problem today, because we don't have any, people who don't have materially, I don't have anything. You have a lot, brother, in you. You have really a lot in you. Your sight, your hearing, health, hands, feet, organs, everything working. That is the great favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So acknowledge the favors of Allah and be habitually grateful and thankful to Allah. Perform salat al-shukr sometimes. Perform saddat al-shukr sometimes. And the Prophet taught us one dua. Let me recite after salah. Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husna ibadati. What is the meaning of this dua? Very comprehensive. Oh Allah, a'inni, help me. Ala dhikrika, to remember you. I don't know how to remember you. Show me. Wa shukrika, and how to thank you and praise you. Your bounties are so much upon me. Show me the way to praise you. Wa husna ibadatik, and how I can beautify my worship to you. Oh Allah, you show me and you give it to me. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a tawfiq and ability, inshallah, that we be those servants of Allah that habitually, on a daily basis, give thanks and appreciation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not limit your thanks to occasions, because Allah's bounties upon you are not on occasions, but for all times. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر لسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، قال تعالى مخبرا وآمرا، إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم وعلى خلفاء الراشدين المهديين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم اجمعين وعلى جميع الصحابه والصحابيات رضوان الله تعالى عليهم اجمعين وعلى المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الاحياء منهم والاموات انك سميع مجيب الدعوات. عباد الله رحمكم الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعيدكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.